my book is about a young girl, Sophie. She's a high school student and she lives in a big city. And she's quite a lonely, lost character. And her, when the book starts, her father just passed away. Her father was a lawyer who defended young kids, jihadists, who went to the caliphate, who were involved with jihadism. Her father was also very interested in religion because he said those two are not connected, and he was interested in the beauty of Islam. And Sophie basically is searching for her father and searching for, well, for some sort of meaning or warmth in her life, and she gets very interested. She wants to convert to Islam, but at the same time finds it difficult, and all is also attracted to the darker side of what she finds online concerning jihadism. Next to, apart from being a writer, I also work as a forensic psychologist, and in that profession I spoke to young people in, that was about maybe 7 years ago, when the caliphate was still there, and some young kids had traveled there and came back to the Netherlands, or others were involved with jihadistic activities online. And as a forensic psychologist, I talked to many young kids in prison. And what really struck me is that they were so different from what I expected them to be, especially the girls. Some of them were quite intelligent, but also very lost, didn't feel at home usually in the Netherlands, wanted to be somewhere else, but didn't really know where to find what they were looking for. And that really interested me. So that was the starting point of trying to get closer to somebody like that, especially the Dutch girls who converted to Islam interested me. Also because when I was 16, 17, I come from a non-religious background. My parents were more anti-religious when I grew up. And I always felt a bit envious of people who were religious. My best friend in high school was a Muslim, and I also wanted to understand that, and in a way I wanted to be a Muslim too, but I knew it would be not for me. So those two things really led me in this direction. Well, I think first of all it's a question of trying to understand it, and so that's, I think, the source for both my lines of work, my work as a forensic psychologist as well as a writer. And I think in literature, it's even a better source to really try and understand somebody else by reading and by writing. So, like I said, what motivated me to write this second book was also the question I had. If I would be 16, 17 now, or, like in 2016, and I was so interested in religion, and I was also a bit lonely and drifting through the streets of the city, would I also have been attracted a little bit to that darker side? I always feel like whenever you start talking to people, what I do in my work, even if they have done some horrendous things that I can't really understand, when you talk to someone, there's always something that binds you. There's always similarities. There's always universal motives behind it. And that's what I think what triggers me for both the books. So for the first book and the second book too. I don't think so, because I'm not writing from a distance. I'm really trying to write from within a person. And of course, looking from outside, of course, I don't agree with pedophilia, or I wish it didn't exist, or I wish violent attacks did not exist, of course. I mean, that's easy to take aside, but it does exist, and unfortunately, and I think it's better to try and understand how some people have come to choose this path, if you can say it was a choice. And that interests me more than to write something with a moral point of view. Yeah, I also find this is more difficult, but at the same time more rewarding, to try and find the more subtle complexities within somebody that makes them do things that, yeah, that I don't agree with, of course, and most people don't, but that's the, the interesting part for me.